Uncover Exciting History by Amy Puetz, revealing America's Christian heritage in short, easy nuggets. Chapter 1. Christ Bearer, Christopher Columbus. Christopher Columbus was born in 1451. As a boy growing up in Genoa, Italy, Columbus had two dreams. One was to sail the untamed seas, and the other was to live up to his name and be a Christ bearer. When Columbus grew up, he developed a plan for reaching the Indies by sailing west. Unsuccessfully, he sought financial help from the King of Portugal. Columbus next headed to Spain, hoping that Ferdinand and Isabella might support him. Christopher anticipated that his intent of proclaiming the Catholic religion to the heathen in the Indies would appeal to the staunch Catholic monarchs of Spain. Although they were interested, they were busy fighting a war against the Moors. Columbus waited. Many years he waited, until finally, in 1492, Ferdinand and Isabella agreed to finance Columbus's voyage across the Ocean Sea, another name for the Atlantic, to the Indies, a general term used to describe the Far East, including China, Japan, and India. Christopher's years of idleness were over. Now he was going to do the work for which he had been born. On August 3, 1492, at the age of 41, Christopher Columbus began his voyage to discover the Indies with 90 men and 3 ships, the Niña, Pinta, and Santa Maria. The fleet spent over a month in the Canary Islands acquiring provisions and having the rudder on the Pinta repaired. Finally, they sailed west. With each passing day, the sailors' fears increased. The notion that people thought the world was flat is a fabricated story started by Washington Irving in his book, History of the Life and Voyages of Christopher Columbus. In his log, Columbus never mentions the sailors being afraid of falling off a flat earth. Instead, they dreaded running out of provisions or being unable to return to Spain since the current was pushing them out to the unknown, and they resented being led by a foreigner. There is no historical evidence that they believed in a flat earth. Columbus never gave in to the crew's desires to turn back. He knew he would find the Indies. One night, as Christopher walked the deck of the Santa Maria, he thought he saw a light in the distance. It was land! The next day, on October 12, 1492, Columbus set foot on an island he christened San Salvador, which means Holy Savior. Columbus praised God for allowing him to reach the Indies. He did not know that he had discovered a new land. Sailing from island to island, Christopher claimed them for Spain. Toward the end of October, he discovered the island of Cuba and thought it must be Japan. He later changed his mind and thought Hispaniola was Japan. Columbus found it hard to explain in words the loveliness of the islands. They were so majestic and beautiful. Regrettably, he only found small amounts of gold. The natives willingly traded what gold they had for the hawk bells, beads, mirrors, and other little trinkets the Spaniards gave them. Columbus had promised to bring back gold, but how could he if he did not discover a mine? Continuing the journey, Christopher next found an island that he named La Isla Española, or Spanish Isle. Today it is called Hispaniola. On Christmas Eve, the crew of the Santa Maria left the steering of the ship to a young boy, and unexpectedly, the ship went aground on a coral reef. Columbus accepted the accident as divine providence, because now the crew would have to establish a fort, and the men who stayed behind could find gold and have it ready when Columbus returned. He called the settlement Navidad, or Nativity, because it was established on Christmas. On January 4, 1493, Columbus and his men set sail.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.